Injection. So let's see what this vehicle is all about. First, let's look at this beautiful paint color, like copper, almost like sun, and check out the LED strips and the LED lighting of this premium sports sedan. You also will have LED lighting also, and with a nice Honda badge, SI, which means sport injection. Around to the side, this vehicle is gonna be equipped. It's riding on Goodyear Eagle F1 tires, so it's gonna do provide a lot of grip. I like the fact that the copper is broken up with the black accent on the mirrors, and you do also have a tilt sunroof. Color is just so beautiful, and it's Goodyear Eagle F1 all around. .235/40, size 18. This one is also complemented by the nice black spoiler on top of the trunk, and you're gonna have the SI badge in here again. Nice exhaust. Dual exhaust. The car is just a beautiful car. One of the last four-door sedans you can have with a manual transmission. The SI only comes in a manual transmission, so this is a car that's made and built with the enthusiast in mind. What's powering this engine is a 1.5-liter four-cylinder VTEC. So it's gonna put out 200 horsepower, and peak torque's gonna come at around 192. You can hear that ticking sound from the direct injection. Have a lot of space to work on if you wanna modify this car. It also does come with a pop rod. Sometimes struts can be a little bit heavier, so with lightness in mind, Honda decided to put a pop rod on it. Now let's talk about the interior of this car. As you can see, Honda kept it pretty simple, but the way how they break up the black in this car with this kind of like a mauve-ish kind of color interior trim. And you're gonna have stitching on the side here. You're gonna have auto up and down for both driver and passenger. And if you come here, this is really nice when you just can tweak anyhow you want to with the vents for the air conditioning. If you come in, you're gonna have traditional analog gauges, and that's what most sport enthusiasts want in their cars. You gotta have the Honda infotainment screen. There's no knobs here to control the screen, so you basically do it with your hands. It is a touch screen, so it's pretty good. You do have Apple CarPlay and Android Auto with the smartphone connection, Sirius XM. And you do have a traditional volume knob. You do have a nice 6-speed manual gearbox. And you do have an electric parking brake. An electronic parking brake. You do have automatic on or off for fuel economy. And you can play with some drive modes here. So you do have sport. Whenever it goes to sport, it makes that color. You go to individual, it shows you that you can set up what you want to, like your steering, your engine, transmission mapping, and exhaust sound. And this is the normal mode, so not anything like fancy. And if you go to the sport mode, you can hear it opens up a little, baffling the exhaust a little bit, so that's pretty cool. All along the lines here, you're gonna have the vents. I like how they built in the vents all the way along this line right here. It's pretty good. I think it's a really good idea, so it doesn't like stick out like a sore thumb. And you come around here, you do have ample storage right here, a little cubby. You do also have a nice cubby space out here also, so it's not that deep, but it's good for basically what you can carry in here. You do have a tilted moonroof, and right here you can push it down. And the lines of the door is still really good. You're gonna have SI badge embroidered in the seats also. The seats are not really separated with the headrest. You just have like just one full sport bucket seats. It hugs you in pretty well, so if you're doing some aggressive driving, you don't really bounce around the place a lot. Throws in this car is very forceful. You have to really like put effort into it to select it in a gear. Go up. You can't just nudge it in a gear like if you're like in a, say like a Nissan Sentra or a Nissan Corolla, where you can just use your finger and just tap it and it rolls into gear. It is like a performance gearbox, so you have to really push it in that gear that you want to. Nice forceful shifts. Goes up in fifth. Oh. Down, up, and reverse is actually all the way out and down. You can see it. So it's pretty nice forceful shifts. This again. It's having a problem going in like fifth gear. Up. This vehicle, though being an enthusiast car, it does come with some nice driver assistance technologies. Usually this steering wheel right here with the two crossings, that means that this vehicle have lane centering. So, and these right here is gonna be the distance control. So this vehicle, you can actually cruise really good on the highway with this car. You do have lane centering, so it does keep the vehicle in its lane, and it will keep a certain distance with a certain speed behind the vehicle that you're traveling with for a very easy drive. It makes your highway cruising a whole lot easier. You get less fatigue, so that's pretty cool. Especially in a manual transmission car. That's just, that shows that technology has come quite a long way. It does have Bose premium sound system also. So I like how this is embedded inside the A-pillar. It's kind of interesting, the trunk button is located right here. I was taking my time to find it, like where's the trunk button at, like where they release it, you know. So it's just a little bit weird that it's put it right there, but at least they put it out of sight. Let's take a look at the trunk. They have pretty decent trunk space and size here. And Honda does give you a fix a flat kit, so I'm guessing these are run flat tires. So enough about this car. It is a beautiful car. It is an enthusiast car. It will provide good levels of grip. This is not necessarily a fast car, but what it does, it provides a lot of fun for the regular enthusiasts who want to drive the car at 10 tenths and don't feel any sense of danger. You just want to roll your gears and just roll with it. I like the fact that they have aluminum paddles also, give it that extra sense of sportiness. Revs are limited to 4.5. Actually put this car in gear. It's not like an economy car where you can just shift easy with your fingers and it slides in. You have to put some force into it, so it does give that that enthusiastic feel, and that's what I like most about this car. It's pretty good, and the gearbox is far enough that you don't miss shifts anyway. You can't mistake third from fifth, but when you get some speed into it, it's very easy shifting, and it does give you downshift rev matching, so you don't really have to do heel toe if you don't want to. Before, it's not fast, but you can drive this thing at 10 tenths and enjoy it, so your money will be well spent if you get a car like this. And that's an easy fifth. What I've noticed is that you can put the car in fifth gear when it's moving, but you cannot do that when you actually have it, you know, stable. So that's an interesting safety feature that Honda put in this vehicle. Exhaust noise that you can hear from the speaker, not from the speaker, from the motor, and it's not piped in, so you do get real exhaust sounds. Oh, this is a lovely car. I like this. Let's check Ford. Sorry, I can't check Ford. Downshift, you get a little blip in the transmission to, you know, so it doesn't jerk the engine around. So that's a really cool feature. I think should be on all manual cars of this century. Very smooth shifting for a performance car. Skipping gears is very easy. this transmission. Hope you enjoyed this overview of this Honda Civic SI, one of the very few sports sedans left with a manual, and they're fairly inexpensive, so us as enthusiasts can pick them up easy. If you do like my content, please subscribe to my channel, like, comment, and share it with your friends if you think they're gonna enjoy it too. I'm trying to grow this channel so I can provide to you more videos. Thank you so much, and until the next video.